अच्छा मैं करती हूँ स्टार्ट।
अब उठना मत,
अच्छा
यहां से उठना नहीं कमरे से, जब तक मेरा लेक्चर नहीं हो जाता है। वो फिर बार बार ब्रेक होता है ना, बताता है मुझे, फिर आता नहीं है ठीक करना।
बाकी डॉक्टर्स जो है मास्क पहन के लेते हैं क्लास?
नदी होती है मैम, मास्क उतारेंगे तो आप थोड़ी साफ
साफ
जाएगी,
जाती
और
है।
मास्क
हाँ
पहनेंगे तो
पहले
थोड़ी
भी तो
क्या
हाँ सही
कम
नहीं
जाएगी।
लगती। कर लो स्टार्ट।
हाँ जी ये
अच्छा
फायर से, हाँ पीछे रखिए
अच्छा अच्छा
बंद हो
अच्छा
जाएगा आपका।
अच्छा 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 से तो आ जाए बच्चे। मैं कर लूँ स्टार्ट?
हाँ जी आपको अभी स्टार्ट करके लेक्चर चल रहा है, टाइम शुरू
अच्छा
हो गया।
अच्छा Assalamualaikum, fourth year. I am Professor Shahida Niazi, and yesterday we were discussing the topic of vasculitis. Regarding blood vessels, we have already, Professor Sohail Chugtai has discussed atherosclerosis, and in my first lecture, we discussed aneurysms. In my second lecture, we started this topic of vasculitis, but yesterday I presume there was a lot of breakage in the internet connection. So I would like to revise a few points regarding the lecture of yesterday. Definition of vasculitis, it's obvious that this is an inflammation of the walls of the blood vessels. And the blood vessels include arteries, arteritis, venules, venulitis, capillaries, capillaritis. And so this was a master diagram in which we were trying to classify the vasculitis according to the size of the blood vessels. And we discussed yesterday that two main mechanisms are the commonest pathophysiological mechanisms, like that is the immune-mediated inflammation, which is also known as the non-infectious etiology. Then we have the infectious etiology, and in which there is direct invasion of the vessel wall by pathogenic microbial organisms. Other causes may aa jaate hain, physical and chemical injuries, which include radiation, trauma, burns, connective tissue disorders, autoimmune diseases, burns and toxins. Why is it important to distinguish between the two types of vasculitis? Is that immunosuppressive therapy, that is steroids, will be helpful in treating immune-mediated vasculitis, but they are going to worsen the infectious type of vasculitis. Regarding the types of vasculitis, non-infectious of the or the immune type of vasculitis, it has a systemic, it is considered to be a systemic type of vasculitis, meaning that it involves the whole body. It can involve multiple blood vessels of the body, as well as the organs which are supplied by those particular blood vessels. And infectious vasculitis is usually a localized type of vasculitis. The immune-mediated or the non-infectious vasculitis ke jo different mechanisms hai, unme we have immune complex deposition-mediated, ANCA-mediated, ANCAs kal humne detail mein kiya the, C-ANCA and P-ANCA. Then the third mechanism is endothelial cell antibody-mediated, cell-mediated, inflammatory bowel disease-mediated, and the vasculitis which is associated with malignancies, that is known as paraneoplastic vasculitis. Immune complex mein, obviously, we have all the autoimmune diseases. Then we discussed the drug-induced type of vasculitis, and the two main culprit drugs are penicillin and streptokinase. It is important to diagnose drug-induced hypersensitivity type of vasculitis, because as soon as you discontinue the drug, there is typically a resolution. The disease, it subsides. And drug-induced type of vasculitis is characterized by having petechial hemorrhages and purpura. And posi-immune means that there is a lack of immune complexes. And this type mainly involves the small blood vessels. And posi-immune ka matlab hai ki there is a lack of immune complexes. And why is there a lack? Either the complexes have been largely cleared at the time of diagnosis, or some other mechanism may be applicable which has caused clearance of the immune complex deposits. ANCAs humne kar liye the, C-ANCA and P-ANCA. C-ANCA is more or less diagnostic of vaginas, and P-ANCA is seen mostly in cases of Churg-Strauss syndrome and microscopic polyangiitis. And remember that the ANCA-associated vasculitis is usually a small vessel vasculitis. Kal humne ye detail mein kiya tha, giant cell temporal arteritis. It is basically a granulomatous type of vasculitis. Large vessel vasculitis mein do entities aati hain. ये अगर आप इस डायग्राम को देखो, द मास्टर डायग्राम, द मास्टर चार्ट, लार्ज वेसल वैस्कुलाइटिस इज अ ग्रैन्युलोमेटस वैस्कुलाइटिस. इसमें आ जाता है जाइंट सेल टेम्पोरल आर्टराइटिस एंड टाकायासुस आर्टराइटिस. हमने कल जाइंट सेल टेम्पोरल आर्टराइटिस किया था. इसमें देयर इज मेनली इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द टेम्पोरल आर्ट्री, द वर्टेब्रल आर्ट्री एंड द ऑफ्थैल्मिक आर्ट्री. ये हमने कल सारा कर लिया था. ये इसकी एक छोटी सी ब्रीफ, इसका एक चार्ट है. टू समराइज, इट इज अ सिस्टेमिक वैस्कुलाइटिस. साइट्स मेनली इन्वॉल्व द टेम्पोरल आर्टरी, कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय हेडेक एंड फेशियल पेन. द पर्सन सेज दैट इट हर्ट्स टू कॉम्ब माय हेयर. देन वर्टेब्रल आर्टरी, ऑफ्थैल्मिक आर्टरी इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज अ कैटास्ट्रोफिक कॉम्प्लिकेशन. इट कैन लीड टू परमानेंट ब्लाइंड. And this is more common in the European countries and the British population. Clinical manifestations include headache, diplopia, facial pain, blindness. And on histological examination, you find granulomas. There is fragmentation of the internal elastic lamina, and this is a granuloma. This is the lumen. This is an elastic tissue. And diagnosis mein humne kaha tha, because it is a segmental disease, adequate length of the biopsy should be taken. It should be about 2 to 3 centimeters, because it is a segmental lesion. Maybe hum us segment mein se le le where granulomas are not present. So that is going to cause misdiagnosis. Now, this is the second entity, and that is Takayasu's arteritis. More or less, this is similar to giant cell temporal arteritis. It is also known as pulseless disease. Pulseless disease meaning that there is a weakening of the pulses of the upper extremities, because isme blood vessels of the upper extremities involve ho rahi hain. To jab unki ल्यूमन उनका कम हो जाएगा, देयर इज अ डिक्रीज इन द साइज ऑफ द ल्यूमन, तो इट इज गोइंग टू लीड टू अ लैक ऑफ पल्स. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज पल्सलेस डिजीज. इट इज अ ग्रैनुलोमेटस वैस्कुलाइटिस mainly involving the medium and the large arteries, and classically it involves the blood vessels which take origin from the arch of the aorta. Iske ilawa there is involvement of the pulmonary blood vessels, the coronary and the renal arteries. In Takayasu's there is intimal hyperplasia, thickening of the vessel wall, mononuclear inflammatory infiltrates are going to be present, granulomas with giant cells, necrosis of the media and collagenous thickening. Ultimately in the yield phase there is going to be collagenous scarring of the vessel wall. So isme intima ka hyperplasia, media ka necrosis hai aur granulomas honge in the media. The lesions may be indistinguishable from those of giant cell temporal arteritis, especially the aortic lesions. And in that case, the distinction is made on the basis of the age of the patient and the gender of the patient. Those who are above the age of 50 years and they are males are designated as having giant cell temporal arteritis, while those under the age of 50 are known as having Takayasu's arteritis. This is Takayasu's arteritis. This is an aortic angiogram. This is the arch of the aorta. This is the brachiocephalic. This is the carotid. And this is the subclavian. You can see the subclavian narrowing, carotid narrowing, and the brachiocephalic showing in that. Jab narrow ho jata hai, this leads to a lack of pulsation in the upper extremity. This is a cut section of the right carotid artery, and you can see this is the lumen, this is the media, this is the lumen, this is a marked thickening of the tunica intima, and this is the media, yeah, gross. This is the microscopic image and you can see these giant cells. So there is a destruction of the tunica media by ye inflammatory infiltrator. Ye sare jo dots blue nazar aa rahe hain, this is the mononuclear inflammatory infiltrate and these arrows point to the multinucleated giant cells. So we finished with large vessel vasculitis, which is giant cell temporal arteritis and Takayasu's. Now coming on to the medium vessel vasculitis. Medium mein do examples hain, polyarteritis nodosa, which is known as Pan and Kawasaki disease. Yeah, aap dekh rahe ho ke these names, they resemble Japanese words. They resemble Japanese words. Takayasubi and Kawasaki. So polyarteritis nodosa is also a systemic vasculitis involving multiple organ, multiple blood vessels. Small or the medium-sized muscular blood vessels are involved, but it does not involve the tiny blood vessels like the arterioles, capillaries, or venules. And remember a very important point, that it does not involve the pulmonary artery. It does not involve the pulmonary circulation. It typically involves the renal and the visceral blood vessels. And isme main cause of death hota hai due to renal failure. 30% patients with polyarteritis nodosa have hepatitis B, anti-hepatitis B surface antigen complexes in the affected vessels. But the cause is not known, but 30% patients, this is a very important point from the MCQ point of view, that 30% of patients with polyarteritis nodosa, they have chronic hepatitis B, with the result that they have hepatitis B antigen complexes, both in the affected vessels as well as in the serum. So polyarteritis nodosa is a segmental. Jis tarah hamara giant cell temporal tha, segmental tha, a particular segment was being involved. Transmural means that there is full thickness involvement of the blood vessel. And it is a necrotizing inflammation. In descending order of frequency, the blood vessels which are mainly involved are the kidney blood vessels. Heart, liver, and gastrointestinal tract. Remember, I'm repeating again that the blood vessels of the pulmonary circulation are not affected. And these are eccentric lesions. They are not circumferential. They involve only a part of the circumference of the vessel wall. And they have a predilection for the branch points. Weakening of the vessel wall is going to lead to aneurysmal dilatation or even rupture. Impaired perfusion is going to lead to ulcerations, infarcts, ischemic atrophy or hemorrhages in the distribution of that particular organ. In polyarthritis nodosa, the acute phase, in the acute phase, there is a transmural inflammation with a mixed inflammatory infiltrate composed of neutrophils, eosinophils, and mononuclear cells. Frequently, it is accompanied by fibrinoid necrosis and luminal thrombosis. Now, these are the features which are seen in the acute phase. In the later chronic phase or the healed phase, there is a nodular thickening. Ab naam se yaad rakho, polyarteritis nodosa. Nodosa means nodule formation. Polyarteritis means involvement of the multiple medium-sized blood vessels. So in regarding the spectrum, all stages of activity from early to mid to late may coexist, suggesting ongoing and recurrent insults. Clinical features, typically young adults are involved, and it is frequently a remitting and episodic disease with symptom-free intervals. The most common manifestations, humne kal bhi padha tha ki jitni bhi vasculitis hain, they are characterized by having a non-specific type of symptoms like fever, malaise, body aches and pains. But isme ek important cheez hai ki there is hypertension, and this hypertension is due to involvement of the renal blood vessel. Renal artery ki involvement ki wajah se there is hypertension. When it involves the blood vessels of the gastrointestinal tract, it is going to lead to pain and bloody stools due to involvement of the blood vessels of the gut. Diffuse muscle aches and pains and peripheral neuritis. Untreated, the disease is fatal, and we have just said that renal artery involvement is the major cause of death in this condition. Therapy, jitni bhi hamari vasculitis hain, the immune mediated vasculitis, they benefit from steroid therapies. Corticosteroids and cyclophosphamide will be beneficial in curing these in 90% cases. Now this is a blood vessel. This is the lumen of the blood vessel. This is, the arrow is pointing to a part of the blood vessel which is not involved. This is the lumen of the blood vessel. And you can see that there is a thrombus within the lumen. This is a, ye hai necrosis. Ye jo pink nazar aa raha hai, this is necrosis. So the second disease which we are going to study in the medium-sized vasculitis. Abhi humne polyarthritis nodosa kiya. Now, this is immune complex mediated. Or the second disease is Kawasaki disease. Kawasaki disease comes under the heading of anti-endothelial cell antibody mediated. Now, Kawasaki disease is very important. This is a disease which is responsible for causing myocardial infarction in children because it involves the coronary blood vessels. It is a disease which usually involves children less than 4 years old. 80% patients are younger than 4 years. It is a febrile self-limited disease. And it involves, it is an arteritis involving the medium-sized blood vessels. Clinical significance of this disease is that it has a predilection for the coronary artery involvement. And when the coronary is involved, Fibrinoid necrosis, rupture, thrombosis, and aneurysmal dilatation can occur in the coronary artery, and this is causing acute myocardial infarction. Kawasaki disease ka dusra naam hai mucocutaneous lymph node syndrome. Abhi main, this is known as mucocutaneous lymph node syndrome. So iski jo डिजीज की जितनी भी मैनिफेस्टेशन है, म्यूको मीन्स देयर इज इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन्स. ये छोटा बच्चा है, यहाँ पे आप देखो इसकी लिप्स की इन्वॉल्वमेंट है, इसके हैंड्स की भी इन्वॉल्वमेंट हो जाती है. म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन्स, कुटेनियस मीन्स स्किन, एंड लिम्फ नोड देयर इज इन्वॉल्वमेंट, देयर इज सर्वाइकल लिम्फ नोड एनलार्जमेंट, लिम्फ एडिनोपैथी. सो इट इज अ सिस्टेमिक वैस्कुलाइटिस involving the small to the medium-sized blood vessels. Sites are the coronary and the cutaneous blood vessels, skin blood vessels and the coronary. Age, sex and ethnicity. Very young children, less than 4 years, and it is a disease which is mostly seen in North America and Japan. Clinical manifestations include fever, involvement of the mucous membranes of the eye, the oral cavity, is going to lead to conjunctival oral erythema and erosions. Cutaneous involvement is going to lead to erythema of the palms, soles and skin rash. And there is going to be lymph node syndrome, means there is going to be enlargement of the cervical lymph node. Clinical course, there is spontaneous remission in most cases. Treatment includes aspirin and immunoglobulins. And the most important dreaded complication is the development of coronary aneurysm with resultant thrombosis. So now we come on to the small vessel vasculitis. Small vessel vasculitis mein sabse pehle aa jata hai microscopic polyangiitis. And microscopic polyangiitis, we studied yesterday that this is a vasculitis involving the small blood vessels. It comes under the heading of posi-immune complex vasculitis. Posi-immune complex vasculitis, lekin inme ANCAs honge. Vaginas mein C ANCA hoga. ANCA stands for anti-neutrophilic cytoplasmic antibody. Microscopic polyangiitis mein you are going to find there is going to be inflammation of the wall of the blood vessels. No eosinophilia, no asthma, and no granuloma formation. So microscopic polyangiitis is a necrotizing vasculitis involving mainly the small blood vessels like the capillaries, arterioles, and venules. The lesions are segmental fibrinoid necrosis of the media. Focal transmural necrotizing lesions, and the lesions morphologically resemble the lesions of polyarthritis nodosa, but they typically involve the tiny small blood vessels as compared to PAN, jisme medium sized blood vessels involve hoti. Therefore, gross infarcts are going to be uncommon in cases of microscopic polyangiitis. Sari lesions are going to be of the same age. अक्यूट, क्रॉनिक एक ही एज में होंगी, हील्ड या वो नहीं होंगी, सेम एज होंगी. पैथोजेनिसिटी, इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी एन इम्यून कॉम्प्लेक्स डेपोजिशन डिजीज, बट देर इज अ पॉसिटी ऑफ इम्यून कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. व्हाई इज देर अ पॉसिटी? बिकॉज आइदर द इम्यून कॉम्प्लेक्सेस आर लार्जली क्लियर्ड बाय द टाइम वी रीच अ डायग्नोसिस, एंड इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ P ANCA का दूसरा नाम है myeloperoxidase ANCAs. And an important point to remember is that microscopic polyangiitis, microscopic है तो it means tiny blood vessels, polyangiitis multiple blood vessels, and it is also known as a hypersensitivity vasculitis or leukocytoclastic vasculitis. In this case, there is fragmentation. Leukocytoclastic, the next figure mein aapko raj. This is leukocytoclastic vasculitis, a wall of the blood vessel. And you can see that this is involved by a large number of neutrophils. Neutrophils ki breakage ho rahi hai. Wall ke andar involve ghus gaye hain, wall ke andar chale gaye. They have entered the wall of the blood vessel, tiny blood vessel. And when they enter the neutrophils, when they enter the wall of the blood vessel, neutrophils ke jo lobes hote hain, 3-4 lobes jo hote hain neutrophils ke, they are undergoing fragmentation. This is known as leukocytoplastic vasculitis, that as the neutrophils enter the wall of the blood vessel, there is fragmentation of the lobes of the neutrophils. Now we come on to Churg-Strauss syndrome. Churg-Strauss syndrome is known as allergic granulomatosis and angitis. It is classically associated with asthma. It is associated with asthma, allergic rhinitis, lung infiltrates, peripheral eosinophilia, as well as extravascular necrotizing granulomas. This is Churg-Strauss. Isme teeno cheeze hain. Eosinophilia bhi hai, allergy ka phenomena hai, asthma hai, and granuloma. So this is Churg-Strauss, skin rash, eosinophilic necrosis, ye sare eosinophils hain. And these are the transient pulmonary infiltrates. It is a systemic vasculitis. Sorry, it is not the medium size. It is a small blood vessels. Involvement of the pulmonary, coronary, and the cutaneous blood vessels. Clinically, allergic rhinitis, bronchial asthma, eosinophilia, and skin. Isme bas aapne moti moti cheezein yaad rakhi. Vaginous granulomatosis is important. It is a necrotizing vasculitis, and it is characterized by three main features. There is a triad of necrotizing granulomas, and these granulomas, they may involve the upper respiratory tract as well as the lower respiratory tract. Lower respiratory tract mein lung aa jayega, upper respiratory tract mein hamara nose, sinuses, and throat aa jayega. Or there is involvement of both the upper and the lower respiratory tract. Ye hain granulomas. Number two, there is a vasculitis, and this vasculitis is also a granulomatous vasculitis. So tissue granulomas ban rahe hain, aur blood vessel ke bhi granulomas, organs ke granulomas ban rahe hain, aur blood vessels ke andar bhi granulomas ban rahe. And it is a disease which involves the small to the medium-sized blood vessels like the capillaries, venules, arteries, and arteries. And ye jo blood vessels jo involve ho rahi hain, ye most commonly of the upper and the lower respiratory tract. Aur jo teesri cheez is disease mein ho rahi hai, that is renal involvement in the form of a focal necrotizing crescentic type of glomerulonephritis. These are the glomeruli. Ye kidney ki biopsy hai. Ye kidney ki biopsy hai. Ye kidney ki biopsy hai. Ye hai glomeruli. This is another group. Ye glomerulus hai. Ye wala. Ye glomerulus hai. Ye uski different capillaries hai. Or this is the crescent which we are talking about. Crescent formation. Jaise hamara moon ka crescent banta hai na, half moon jo hamara hota hai. This is crescent. Not half moon, usse bhi kam. This is crescent formation. These are the glomerular capillaries. Ye different glomerular capillaries. Crescent formation is the character. Jab aap log kidney padhoge tab aapko pata chalega ki crescents kya hote hain. Bas itna aap yaad rakho ki vaginous granulomatosis is characterized by the triad of three features: granulomas in the upper and the lower respiratory tract, necrotizing granulomas of the blood vessels, and glomerular nephritis with crescent formation of the kidney blood vessels. It is jab bhi granuloma hota hai to it means that it is a TB mein bhi jab hum kehte hain granuloma banta hai to it is indicative of a T cell mediated hypersensitivity reaction. Aur isme bar bar maine aapko bataya ki Proteinase 3, that is C ANCA, is present in 95% cases of Vaginismus granulomatosis. So the granulomas which occur in this disease are the necrotizing granulomas. Necrosis is typically having a geographic pattern of necrosis. And these granulomas, they may unite or coalesce to form visibly, radiologically visible nodules, which can undergo cavity formation or cyst formation. There is an accompanying vasculitis. Zahiri baat hai, granuloma hoga, to usme fibroblastic proliferation bhi hogi, giant cells bhi honge, or leukocytic infiltrate. Vaginas, predilection for males. This is the gross of the lung lesion. This is the lung lesion, and you can appreciate that this, ye lung, ye granulomas hain. They have coalesced to form nodules, and this nodule has undergone cavitation to form a cyst-like or a cavitary lesion. This is the lung, and this is the microscopic feature. Jahan pe arrow hai, these are the giant cells. So, Vaginas, to summarize, Vaginas is a systemic vasculitis of the small or the medium-sized blood vessels, mainly involves the pulmonary blood vessels, the renal blood vessels, and the blood vessels of the nasal and the paranasal sinuses. Males are affected more commonly than females at an average age of 40 years. Clinical features are going to be pneumonitis, nodular pulmonary infiltrates, chronic sinusitis, crescentic type of glomerulonephritis. We have just seen the figure of the glomerulus, nasal ulcers, and discharge. On pathological examination, you are going to find granulomas, necrotizing granulomas having geographic necrosis, crescent formation in the glomeruli, and nasal granulomas. So diagnosis is based on the finding of C ANCA or proteinase 3 ANCA positivity. And vaginas is characterized by the triad of having granulomatous vasculitis, granulomas, necrotizing granulomas in the upper and the lower respiratory tract, and renal involvement in the form of crescentic glomerulonephritis. Treatment, cyclophosphamide. Complications include rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis, pulmonary and upper airway obstruction. Now we come on to the Burgess disease. Ye aap logon ne I think padha hua bhi hai. Burgess disease is thromboangitis obliterans. Thromboangitis obliterans, meaning that this disease is characterized by forming occlusions, thrombotic occlusions, which are obliterating the lumen of the blood vessel. Typically, they involve the medium-sized and the small arteries, that is the tibial artery and the radial artery. And these are almost exclusively seen in heavy cigarette smokers about before the age of 35. Male cigarette smokers, heavy cigarette smokers, and usually this entity, it involves the tibial and the radial arteries. There is a segmental thrombosing, acute and chronic inflammation or vasculitis of the medium size and the small arteries. Here you can see a medium-sized blood vessel. This is the lumen. And this is the lumen which is occluded by a thrombus. Ye pura ka pura thrombus hai. Ye halki si aapko lumen nazar aa rahi hai yahan pe. Thodi si lumen nazar aa rahi hai. The whole of the lumen is occluded by this thrombus, and this thrombus is containing abscesses. It is containing neutrophils. The early manifestations include a superficial nodular phlebitis. Veins ki bhi involvement ho jaye. Phlebitis is inflammation of the veins. Or ye nodular form mein, superficial veins are going to be involved forming nodules. There is going to be cold sensitivity of the Raynaud's type in the hands. Radial artery agar involved hogi to. And in the foot, there is going to be pain in the instep of the foot, which is induced by exercise. And this is called इन स्टेप क्लॉडिकेशन, जैसे ही आप चलते हो दो तीन स्टेप्स लेते हो तो आपको ना अपने पाँव के मीडियल एस्पेक्ट पे एक्सट्रीम एक्सक्रूशिएटिंग पेन होती है एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड इन स्टेप क्लॉडिकेशन. हैंड्स में रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना होगा, फुट में इन स्टेप क्लॉडिकेशन. द पेन इज एंड अल्टीमेटली एज द डिजीज प्रोग्रेसेस द डिजीज बिकम्स सिवियर एंड पेन में अकर इवन एट रेस्ट. अब अक्लूजन तो दोनों की हुई है, इसको डिफरेंशिएट करना होता है फ्रॉम द इनसफिशिएंसी व्हिच इज कॉज्ड बाय एथेरोस्क्लेरोसिस. दोनों में द डिफरेंशियल पॉइंट इज पेन. इन द अक्लूजन ऑफ बर्जर्स डिजीज देयर इज गोइंग टू बी इंटेंस पेन, वेयर एज इन द इनसफिशिएंसी और द अक्लूजन व्हिच इज कॉज्ड बाय एथेरोस्क्लेरोसिस, एथेरोस्क्लेरोसिस इज अ साइलेंट किलर. And this pain which occurs in Burgess disease is due to involvement of the nerves. Iske alawa there are going to be, because blood supply compromise ho rahi hai, to kya hoga? There is going to be chronic ulcerations of the toes, feet, fingers and frank gangrene. Abstinence from cigarette smoking will be curative in the early stages and it often brings dramatic relief from further attacks, but only if cigarette smoking is quitted at an early stage. Now this is Burgess disease. Here aap dekh rahe ho, swollen feet. This is Raynaud's phenomenon, cyanosis and swelling of the fingers. This is the same diagram, jisme there is a thrombotic occlusion of the medium-sized blood vessel. It is a limited vasculitis, localized type of vasculitis. हमने पढ़ा था कि जितनी भी हमारी vasculitis जो immune mediated होंगे, they are usually as a general rule they are systemic, but the infectious type of vasculitis are usually localized. So this is localized. This is a localized type of vasculitis. Sites are the tibial and the radial arteries. Age, less than 35 years. Males are affected and smokers, Asian populations are mainly affected. Clinically, there is intermittent claudication, ultimately progressing on to rest pain due to neural involvement. There is going to be ulceration. Ulceration of the toes and the fingers. Morphologically, there is going to be granulomatous inflammation, thrombi with central microabscesses. Diagnosis obviously is based on biopsy. Treatment consists of avoidance of smoke. Other disorders which are associated with vasculitis. We discussed that jitne bhi hamare autoimmune disorders hain, like rheumatoid arthritis, SLE, cancer associated with paraneoplastic vasculitis, systemic illnesses like mixed cryoglobulinemia, antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, Henoch-Schönlein-Purpura, they are all autoimmune disorders which are associated with vasculitis. Now coming on to the infectious type of vasculitis. Infectious type of vasculitis is usually a localized arteritis. There is direct invasion of the vessel wall by infectious agents, which could be bacteria or fungi. Amongst the fungal organisms, Spergillus and Mucor are the main culprits. Now, infectious vasculitis, it can occur as a localized tissue infection. Direct invasion of the vessel wall, or it can occur adjacent to certain infective processes in the body. Less commonly, infectious vasculitis may be due to hematogenicity. Now, what are mycotic aneurysms? Mycotic aneurysms are this infectious vasculitis can lead to weakening of the wall of the blood vessel, dilatation, and jo bhi infection ki wajah se jo aneurysms bante hain, unko hum kehte hain mycotic aneurysms. Ye humne pichhi dafa padha. They are known as mycotic aneurysms. और इनमें क्या हो जाता है, थ्रोम्बोसिस एंड ऑब्वियसली इन्फेक्शन. इट कैन अल्टीमेटली प्रोग्रेस ऑन टू अ सिस्टेमिक डिजीज लीडिंग टू बैक्टीरियल मेनिनजाइटिस, लीडिंग ऑन टू इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द अंडरलाइन वेन. रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना ये हम आपको ट्यूटोरियल डिस्कशंस में कराएंगे. आप लोग ऐसे पढ़ लेना कि रेनॉल्ड्स होता क्या है. इट इज अ फिनोमेना विच रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम एन एग्जैजरेटेड वेजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन ऑफ द डिजिटल आर्टरीज एंड आर्टेरियोस. देयर इज अ पैरोक्सिस्मल पेलर एंड साइनोसिस. कभी हैंड्स एंड फिंगर्स फिंगर्स ऑफ द हैंड्स पीले पड़ जाते हैं, कभी ब्लू हो जाते हैं. Alternatively, paroxysmal means alternatively there is going to be paler or blueness of the digits of the hands or feet. Infrequently, you can also experience Raynaud's phenomena on the tip of the nose, the ear lobes, and the lips. Characteristically, the involved digits they show a play of colors. पहले red हो जाएंगे, फिर white हो जाती हैं, और फिर blue in color. पहले रेड होंगी, फिर ये व्हाइट होने लग जाती है, देन देयर इज ब्लू कलर. दिस इज द फिनोमेना ऑफ कलर चेंजेस विच आर सीन इन रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना, प्रोग्रेसिंग फ्रॉम प्रॉक्सिमल टू मोस्ट डिस्टल. रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना मे बी अ प्राइमरी डिजीज एंटिटी और मे बी सेकेंडरी टू अ वैरायटी ऑफ कंडीशंस. इसलिए कहते हैं प्राइमरी रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना which was previously called Raynaud's diseases. जी 9:45 हो गए. अच्छा जी अच्छा. प्राइमरी रेनॉल्ड्स फिनोमेना इज वॉज प्रीवियसली कॉल्ड रेनॉल्ड्स डिजीज. इट इज एन एग्जैजरेशन ऑफ द सेंट्रल एंड द लोकल वेजोमोटर रिस्पॉन्सेज टू आइदर कोल्ड और इमोशनल स्ट्रेसेस एंड इट इज प्रेसिपिटेटेड by cold or emotional stresses and it is usually seen in young girls. 3-5% of the general population is affected by Raynaud's phenomena. Structural changes aamtaur pe nahi hoti, absent except late in the course of the disease, and the main feature which we see is intimal thickening. Long standing cases, obviously you are going to see skin atrophy, ulceration because of lack of blood supply and ischemic gangrene. These are rare consequences. Secondary Raynaud's phenomena, it occurs as a disease manifestation of some other disease. It occurs as a clinical manifestation, as a clinical manifestation of some other disease. Raynaud's itself is not a Raynaud's itself is not a disease. In fact, it is a clinical manifestation characterized by vascular insufficiency of the extremities, and it is usually seen in autoimmune diseases like SLE, scleroderma, and even it can be seen in atherosclerosis. So this is a figure showing sharply demarcated pallor of the distal figures. I'm sorry, तस्वीर इतनी अच्छी नहीं आ रही. This is due to closure of the digital arteries, lack of blood supply in the digital arteries. This is cyanosis. Yeah, you can appreciate that this is redness. Redness progressing on to blueness, cyanosis हो रही. Tips इसके आप देखो हल्के हल्के purple हो. Thank you. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum.
हमारे जो टाइम टेबल है वो डिफरेंट है, इसके पास डिफरेंट होता है. जी जी जी
मैम, वो तो मेडिकल वो मेडिकल एजुकेशन से मैम, आप बुरहान होते हैं उधर, उनसे एक दफा बात करो. क्योंकि अभी मैंने टू ग्रुप्स को डिवाइड किया था ना, आम वाले और वो है ना,
जी 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 जी
50% फैकल्टी आ रही है, क्योंकि अब गवर्नमेंट ने तो कह दिया कि 11
तारीख तक,
अब हमें क्या पता आज सर्कुलर को रोके।